And we look to see what our new normal can look like. It can be very exciting. Today, we're going to talk to you a bit about what we have come to understand and learn during this COVID experience. We are in our second, almost at the end of our second full month of quarantining, shelter in place, staying safer at home, and there's a lot of lessons that we have gotten out of this experience, and we really want to share with you what we've learned so far. I know there's going to be more that we'll get from this, and more ahas, more awarenesses, and more growth and learning. That's been one of our focuses during this time, is to look for opportunities and to see where we can understand more about ourselves, do more introspection, and see where we can really look at what we need to do differently and prioritize differently. There's been a lot of a really good learning that's come so far out of this for all of us, and also, we know there is a lot of fear around this experience. So we want to address all of those things, mostly by understanding that what this brings up primarily for everybody is that our health has got to be a priority in our lives. Absolutely, without question. That is a fundamental understanding that we have come to in this COVID experience so far. That we can't just put off to the side what we need to do to make ourselves healthier. Because as I have seen it and experienced it, the people who are taking care of themselves are the ones who are thriving through this experience. And that is not an accident. And they aren't just lucky. It's because they are embracing the elements of health that are allowing them to have that experience, especially during this time of incredible fear and the unknown, and we don't know what tomorrow is going to bring. We really want to go through and give you ideas about how you can have that experience even when we aren't in the midst of a pandemic and the crisis of it and the fear around it. We want to really look at how can we be one of those people who is embracing our health and is making our health a priority daily, consistently, so that we can always thrive, not just now, but always. We're going to go through the elements that we know allow for that experience, and we're going to talk about how the work that we do fits into it. We are the chiropractors at Oasis Wellness Partners, so I'm going to start there because it's a subject near and dear to my heart. And we know that getting adjusted does so many things for the body. It allows your nervous system to function more fully. It allows you to manage stress more easily. This is a very high stress time, and the people who are consistently getting adjusted through it are getting through it with so much more ease. They can breathe deeper, they can be more calm, and they're not as reactive and in this fight or flight state all the time. So those elements of getting adjusted and allowing your body to be more resilient is a huge factor, not just in a crisis time, but all the time in our lives. Making sure that the nervous system is adaptable and flexible and can manage the stress that we experience all the time in our lives is such a critical, critical component of our health and well-being.
One of the other pieces of the nervous system that I have found personally for myself and also watching the practice members is the clarity that being out of fight or flight gives you to make good choices. When you're not in fear and when you are in faith, you can start to look at your environment and say, oh, okay, I do have some more time. What are some of the things that I have been wanting to do? And finding the places for those expressions, the places in your day and your time to do that. And I know, I was just talking to some practice members the other day, that they have been going through almost like the stages of loss. Kubler-Ross did some work on death and dying. And the stages of loss have been there for many of us. You know, some people have lost their ability to be social. Some people have lost their ability to go to their work. Some children have lost the social engagement with being with their teachers and their friends. Teachers have lost that ability. So when that loss comes, we go through several phases. We are angry. We are sad. We are depressed. We go through all of this, and this is all real. And so when we get adjusted, our nervous system is able to tap into, where am I right now? How am I doing right now? I feel sad. Well, why am I sad? And then we can use some of the tools. One of the practitioners that we have here at Oasis is Leah Wentworth, and she does work with tapping. It's called emotional freedom technique or training. Emotional, stages of loss, they're all there. And freedom, the freedom to know that you can go through them and still be safe and still have adaptability to your world. Go through your day even though you may be sad. She has done several, while we've been in this situation, online workshops where people can literally go and learn this technique to be able to free themselves to be more adaptable to these changes. So that was a really neat conversation I've had with practice members that have come in and been like, there's no reason I should be angry today, but I'm angry. And you think, I thought to myself, yeah, I've had that too. I've had some days where I've been like, oh, this is frustrating. And when you are adjusted, you can then have your nervous system come out of that fight or flight, go back into restore and rejuvenate, and think to yourself, what tools do I have? One of them might be go online and go to our Scarborough Maine Yoga. All of her teachers are doing yoga online, and it's phenomenal. I've gone to several classes, and my yoga practice in the other world, the world pre-COVID, was, I'll get to class, and I didn't make time for it. Honestly, I made it occasionally, but now I have made it a priority, and I see a total difference in how I recover from fitness, how I recover from emotional days. These tools are available, and I remember in the very beginning when this all happened, I saw a little sign somewhere, and it said something like, wow, I used to say I didn't have time for things. That may not be why I didn't do them, because now we have the time. And what I'm hoping and praying is that for myself and for all the people in our community here, that when this all comes and turns around, we keep these habits, because these habits are what have kept us healthy and what has allowed us to thrive during this time. And more than just survive, we want to thrive. We want to take these elements, adapt to it, and get even better. To be come out of it and say, yeah, that was a tough time, but boy, I used some amazing tools. One of the other pieces is relationships, making sure you're staying in relationship, keeping in contact, writing letters to people, writing notes and thank you and gratitude notes. No better thing you can do. Keeping in contact with relationships with people is really critical right now, and something you can do through our community here at Oasis, but it's a really important piece that I think is paramount.
And that's another piece we want to look at in terms of continuing healthy practices, because we do have more free time right now, but we're not always going to be in this time period. So we need to look at, where am I going to prioritize next? And how am I going to prioritize when my time is more taken up and I don't have as much time at home? And understanding that we have got to make our health a priority is so critical. And using our adjustments, using yoga, using massage, like we have here at the office, making sure that we get appointments for reflexology, using the services that are available to you that allow your body to really experience its fullest potential for health, and making sure that it becomes a routine for us. You know, I've gotten into a practice of working out 5 days a week as we've been home more, and as I get back into work and working every day, I may not make 5 days a week a priority, but it's going to be more than I used to do before, which was just 2 or 3 days a week. So finding that balance and knowing that we need to be gentle with ourselves and we need to take time for ourselves. It's a really critical piece of learning that I have gotten from this, that be gentle. Be gentle with yourself. Be gentle with other people. And carry that through. Like, let that become our new normal, right? where can we look to see what our new normal can look like? It can be very exciting. And when you use the tools that we have available here at Oasis Wellness Partners, you are going to be able to really understand and experience what that new normal can be. It's going to be beautiful. We're really looking forward to it.